also acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we're gathering today and pay respects to elders past and present, and to all the colleagues who are involved in this conference. And can I also just reiterate the Minister's thanks to all of you for the extraordinary work you do and the relationship, the collaboration you have with our departmental staff across the state. I am going to start with a couple of deficits, though, and contrary to what Peter Kenyon had to say earlier, I've got too many slides. They're too busy, and I'm going to go through them too quickly. But they will be available through Community Door, and indeed there'll be some extra slides in the full pack. And I probably also won't have a chance to talk as much as I'd really like to talk about the really practical innovations that I hear about every day when I also get to go and visit services, non-government organisations, community centres, neighbourhood centres, our child safety service centres and our disability service centres. Because that's the real power of what we've got going on in the department around our renewal agenda is actually the innovation, the extraordinary energy and momentum innovation that I'm seeing and hearing about every day through YAMA or on my visits to services and NGOs. So thank you to all of those of you who are participating in those efforts. Look, I'm going to scoot through these pretty quickly so that we can actually get onto some dialogue. We've got some drivers. This sort of reflects, I guess, the big mandates, the big authorising documents from government for our renewal agenda. The Queensland Commission of Audit, the Carmody Inquiry Report, the government's commitment to the National Disability Insurance Scheme, the Public Sector Renewal Charter and Values, its contestability framework, and as Jamie's mentioned, the Queensland Plan, and that's an incredibly important framework and tool for us and for this sector. And I'm really pleased Jamie was able to speak a little about that. Look, the other driver, and one that really probably goes more strongly to the personal motivations and values and commitments of the staff of the department, and indeed all of you here, I'm sure, and the intrinsic motivation that all of us bring to our work in this sector, is the question about whether we're doing good enough. We bring truckloads of values, but what this change environment and those renewal drivers that I mentioned on the previous slide have called us to ask is, are we creating value? Are we making a difference? Are we actually shifting the dial on disadvantage? The question that Peter Kenyon challenged us with earlier. Are we the sort of organisation, indeed, are we the sector, are we the system that's actually making a difference in people's lives? So for us, that's the real burning platform. That's what's really driving and motivating the change agenda in the department. And our challenge over the last 12 months or so, 18 months, has been to try and turn that burning platform into a burning ambition. So we have a very ambitious agenda around the sort of organisation that we want to be in the human service amongst government agencies in Australia. And we have a really deliberate and determined change model as an organisation. This is not about where we want to get to. It's not our end state, our destination. But it is about the method and the how and the focus we have as a chain, leading change within our organisation and also leading with the sector across the system. But at its core is a focus on enabling Queenslanders to improve their lives. And it is around, and that's certainly recognised, the context that people live their lives, their families, their communities, their friends, their communities. And indeed, it also drives us to a focus on outcomes and a focus on value. Are we contributing to people being able to improve their lives? Look, this is a very busy slide, and it sort of just goes to indicate, I use this inside the department, to indicate, I guess, there's lots of moving parts that we're trying to mobilise and get going to gear up to deliver the sort of change we've got going on across the organisation. And really what it doesn't actually capture is the beauty and the value and the momentum of the energy and that's coming through our staff and the initiative that they're taking to drive change in the organisation. This is a slide, I guess, that the real point of this is to show that every part of the department is actually undergoing profound and transformational change over the next 3, 5, 10 years. The Minister touched on our transition into the NDIS, the biggest social reform in Australia since Medicare, as she said. Our social investment reform, and this is part of the broader social services reforms that she also referred to, driven by the Social Services Cabinet Committee. And of course, the child and family reforms, the government response to Carnegie that Jamie has mentioned. I guess what we're endeavouring to do is take both a really rigorous, robust, planned and programmed approach to that, but also to encourage agility and flexibility, responsiveness, creativity, design, the sorts of things that Jamie has mentioned that are the real drivers for innovation and change and growth and improvement internationally. So, look, I'll really touch on these only really briefly. I guess the most important point about, and Jamie's already spoken about the overall architecture for the government's response to the Carmody report, is that we've got a really historic opportunity over the next 5 to 10 years with the roadmap, is to totally change the balance of investment and the focus of effort around working with vulnerable families across Queensland. At the moment, 70% of the investment goes at the back end of the tertiary system. Over the next 5 years, we'll start to balance that. Over 10 years, we've got an opportunity to totally turn that on its head. And we really appreciate the contributions and the partnerships that are emerging in that work. And we do know that there's a tension between the desire for co-design and co-production and the very busy schedule we have to deliver on that roadmap and to get that investment on the ground. And I'm happy to come back to that. And social investment reform, really, really similar agenda to what Tim outlined from the Department of Social Services. And indeed, lots of opportunities, as Tim said, to actually get our act together across two levels of government. I hope you've seen the Social and Human Services Investment Blueprint, and I hope you're starting to feel practically some of the benefits of particularly the red tape reduction initiatives that are underway. The streamlined contracting, same agenda as Tim's outline, single contract per organisation, whatever programs and initiatives you're funded with. And indeed, in the program space, many of you have contributed to our thinking about how do we dramatically rationalise our programs. From 100, I think there's 94, there's more, there's 114 or so programs and initiatives, and we're reducing those to 9 funding areas. And those draft specs, that new program architecture, is on our website now, and thank you for those of you who've contributed to the development of that. Disability reform, I've sort of touched on really critical issues for the sector, for the disability sector, but also the mainstream and other community service sectors. And I am really conscious of the relationship we have with NDS and the disability sector, but all of the community service sector needs to get their head around what the NDIS means for and the opportunities that we provide for Queenslanders with disability. And of course, we're doing our best to work across the government to ensure that happens well as well. One of the things that we are really challenging our staff about is the customer experience and customer service and customer results. And in fact, I would digress for a moment just to take issue with, I guess, contest one of Peter's key core themes earlier around people as citizens, not customers. Well, I actually happen to disagree. I've long been a believer since I've worked in the NGO sector and through lots of roles in government that we all actually have multiple identities and interests. We are citizens, we are consumers of services, we're members of communities. And I think that it's that rich array of interests and identities, interactions that we have that we all need to grapple with. Where we are weakest, and this is no disrespect to the fantastic work of our departmental staff, is actually truly engaging customers, engaging citizens and customers. And we're really challenging our staff to think about and skill up and gear up about the way in which we work with people. And really everything else that Peter said today resonates very strongly for me, and I'm happy to come back to that theme as well if anyone wants to discuss that. Engaging stakeholders, as Jamie said, as Mark's outlined, lots of challenges to really transform the relationship we have with the sector. I know there's a long history of partnership, and often it's a word that we've used and abused. We are endeavouring to do more co-design, and we absolutely see the future as about co-producing those outcomes and results for Queenslanders and our communities. And we are learning and doing and hoping to improve along the way. I would encourage you, I think there are things that we can do, like through the use of Yammer. Peter's probably going to mention the social service Yammer group that's been launched. We've just started the Child and Family Reform External Yammer Group. All the folk who are involved in the local service alliances, the regional child and family committees, the statewide advisory group on a big social media platform. So if you're not using it, I'd really encourage you to think about how you can do it. It's been one of the major drivers for the renewal agenda in the department. You can see there some of the results from our last employee opinion survey. And I'm absolutely convinced that one of the reasons for that is we've actually got this extraordinary dialogue going on now through the organisation using Yammer. We had 220 people using it last December. We've got 4,500 people using it today. And just to see every day the rich sharing of learnings, ideas, innovations, experiences, training, it's fantastic. We're also really conscious we actually need to account for progress, for our achievements, for our learnings. And you'll start to see on our website, and we'll share and post through e-letters and so on, a lot more about, you know, what progress are we making, what difference are we making. The beauty will be when we can get to be able to say more about the difference we're making in individual people's lives. Really quickly, we've had a wave of sort of back office red tape reduction initiatives in the last couple of years, the contracts, the programming, reporting reductions and so on. I'm chairing a social services and community safety CEOs group, sits under the cabinet committee, and we're gearing up to engage with the sector about wave two reforms. And so joint commissioning, shared gateways and tools, there's a whole lot of stuff that we've talked about that we're really keen to engage with and actually drive as a sort of a next wave of reform, which is around a much more integrated approach. And indeed, Tim, to engage with your department in terms of how we can do some of this stuff together. Our destination as a department, this is what I say to our staff. I don't know exactly what it's going to look like. We'll certainly be leaner as the DS part of the department goes into the National Disability Insurance Scheme. But they give you some of the ideas about the sort of organisation we will be in 5 to 10 years' time. So I'm going to leave it there, and I'm very happy to come back to any of those themes in our discussion. Thank you very much.